Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is Studi Crypto, where we simplify crypto for the average investor. And in this video, we will be discussing the recent AMA from Sphere Finance. And guess what? No more rebases. That's right, Sphere Finance is going deflationary. So in this video, we're going to do a breakdown of what exactly that means, all of their latest investments, and how this could help you out if you are a holder of this protocol. So stay tuned. Before we do so, please make sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. This is Studi Crypto, where we simplify crypto for the average investor. We discuss all things crypto, all new crypto news, everything relevant to crypto. So if you are new, please give this video a thumbs up, as it really helps out our algorithm, and also subscribe. This way we can keep on growing and growing and growing. Finally, remember, everything discussed in this channel is not financial advice. This is simply just information for your educational purposes so that you can make your own informed decision on your investments. Okay, so let's get right into it. Sphere Finance recently had an AMA and it was jam-packed. Man, there has been so much going on with this project, but just to pretty much put everything in a nutshell, they are building an entire ecosystem. So let's go over all of the 12 things that were discussed in the AMA. They pretty much discussed their limited supply of the new Sphere tokens, the tokens collected in the past month that will be burned, which is 4.7 of circulating supply. And this is amazing because they still have more to burn. In the past month, we have successfully launched Dystopia, 24 million total value lock, and Penrose, 15 million total value lock. Also, they are going to burn a lot more tokens in the new treasury contracts that they were stated. They already accumulated quite a bit of pen tokens as well. Preon will also be playing a role in generating revenue for Sphere. With these revenues, we will burn and buy back Sphere. They talked about their treasury, their dashboard, proxy contracts, and new things that are coming in the works. One of the cool things they also have is that they will be moving their liquidity pools with a stable pool USD Plus in the upcoming weeks and months. We will be building a lot of revenue stream for Sphere. So keep in mind, there are no more rebases, but one of the things that Sphere is looking to do is force appreciation. So what that means is, by you holding the tokens, by them having all of these different types of investments, now, of course, you will not be gaining passive income, but they are looking at it from a long-term perspective, that the price will increase because there is so much going on the back end, and revenue will constantly be shared with a lot of the holders because of all of these different projects that they have going on. So by also burning and getting rid of a lot of these tokens and having a locked supply, that means there is a finite amount of Sphere. What will that do? That will pretty much increase the value of Sphere, which is pretty good because in this bear market right now, things are not really looking pretty strong for a lot of crypto projects. And by constantly minting and constantly creating new tokens, you're sort of diluting and making your project inflationary. So they are going fully deflationary. They are having a cap supply for the amount of tokens that are out there, and they are also investing in other projects. Their goal eventually is to get listed into a centralized exchange. Now keep in mind, if they are listed in a centralized exchange and they are, say, a rebase token, that honestly I don't really see happening, because many centralized exchanges don't even have the capability to have a token and constantly be giving out rewards to individuals on a daily basis. So by doing this move, this is a long-term play. They are looking to increase the price of Sphere, and also they are looking long-term. Many times Sim has spoken and he has said that, hey, he's not in this for the short term. He's in this for the long-term game so that he can build something that's big. As he always says, the S&P 500 of crypto. So let's get into some of the things that they are doing to just benefit us, the holders. One of the things is overnight finance. So this is a USD Plus. What they are looking to do is move their liquidity from WMATIC to USD Plus. Now, they are not completely abandoning WMATIC. So whenever WMATIC is doing well, they can always switch back and forth. Whenever WMATIC is not doing well, they can always use this USD. And what this USD Plus is that it is pretty much a stable coin that is pegged to USDC, 1-to-1. USD Plus stablecoin can be instantly minted and redeemed to USDC 1-to-1. Simply replace USDC with USD Plus stablecoin and start getting passive yield where it didn't exist before. On a weekly basis, you're seeing about 8.6% that you are able to get. So it is pegged 100% collateralized with assets immediately immediately convert it into USDC, because we know we want to make sure that it's pegged one-to-one. We see what happened with the whole Terra Luna thing, which was the whole fiasco, so we want to make sure that it's fully pegged. Risk portfolio assets are picked primarily to avoid losses on daily basis, 3 to 4 segments away from zero, no exposure to algorithmic stables. USD Plus can replace USDC in pools and lending protocols. 2, yield generating. And 3, there is also some insurance that they are later looking to do. So you can come on this website and you can check this out for yourself. But this is a great play because you can actually invest in this protocol, and you can also use USD Plus to invest in other yield and other liquidity pools as well. Which brings me to another project that they are invested heavily in, which is the Dystopia project. Dystopia is pretty much like a curve. I'm not sure if many of you are familiar with curve. It's sort of like a one-shop stop. You can come, you can swap, there's liquidity pools, there's voting, there's going to be rewards. There's many things that are going to be happening here that they already have had a successful launch as well. And Sphere is also heavily involved in this. This is another way for them to generate some profits. Finally, they are also looking to boost those liquidity rewards through Penrose. They have already invested in Penrose, and they also have some Pen tokens as well that are valued pretty decently. Now, Penrose is fairly new, but it has been doing pretty well since launch. So again, you can come on this website as well and check this out for yourself. But just to give a quick update of how this works, is that it pretty much just boosts your reward from your liquidity pairs that you have going on, so which is a cool thing as well. Penrose is to Dystopia what Convex is to Curve. Again, if you're familiarized with Convex and Curve, you would know exactly what that means. But pretty much they just complement each other on a nice basis. You're on one end having your liquidity pools, and over here you're pretty much getting different boosts added on to that for you. Now, another thing that they have going on will be the Galaxy Marketplace. The Galaxy Marketplace is pretty much just a way for Sphere to not have a price impact by a whale. So say, for example, the Galaxy Marketplace will be a place where you can come on and you can pretty much sell your tokens for stable tokens, and you can sell them at a discount. Now, the great thing about the Galaxy Marketplace is that other individuals can also come on there and also purchase tokens as well, but they are not minting new tokens. There is a limited supply cap, so that is going to prop up the value because there is going to be demand for Sphere. The hope is, because there are only a certain amount of tokens, the value will go up. So now with this Galaxy Marketplace, there's going to be an exchange of tokens, the selling of tokens, buying of tokens, but they are not creating new tokens. They are simply just having tokens, burning tokens constantly, and at the same time, other individuals could come and also buy tokens as well. Remember, by building this entire ecosystem, essentially what they are doing is they are literally creating revenue. And by creating revenue, this is pretty much forcing the price of Sphere to go up. So let's say you invested $50. They invest that $50 in all of these protocols to try to hopefully get back $60, $70, $80. And from those $80, now that same $50 that you invested is worth much more. So you're getting exposure to many other protocols by investing in Sphere, sort of like a hedge fund, but not necessarily a hedge fund, because of course it's crypto. I don't want to use the word hedge funds, but they are investing in many other products, especially through the quantum liquidity and things of that nature. And they are looking to build the future of Sphere and make it into something bigger than what it is currently. Again, think of it as a long-term play. I'm curious to see how this is going to play out, because as we all know, right now, crypto's not really looking so good. Things are looking down, but the price of Sphere has been looking pretty decent recently, especially ever since all of these announcements. It went up literally over 200%. So, you know, I mean, I'm curious to see what's going to happen. Let's look at the 5-day chart. As we see right here, it has been on an uptrend. Let's see how much this continues going, and hopefully they can bring some revenue for a lot of holders, because this has pretty much taken a major hit. Well, there you have it. This is Study Crypto. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Thank you, and see you next time.